I am grateful to the examples that I've had in my life because they have served as anchors in times in my life when it came time for me to stand on my own. Having grown up here in Utah, I always seemed to take the church for granted, but I will never forget the day when my parents broke the news to me that my Uncle Jimmy had purchased a theater in a small town in the Ozark Mountains called Branson, Missouri, and that we were going to be moving as a family to the Show Me State. Well, I was a sophomore in high school at the time, and believe it or not, I didn't take the news all that great. Well, I had everything I ever wanted here in Utah. My friends, kids I had known my whole life. I was about to get my driver's license. I was about to enter the dating scene. I'd already picked out the girls I wanted to go out with. I had my high school, temples in my backyard, a living prophet just up the street. And now we'd be moving to some strange land I'd never heard of before to perform twice a day except for Sundays to predominantly senior citizen age crowds. I wasn't thrilled. In fact, I think you can still see my claw marks in the local highway, I-15, where they had to drag me. But you know what? We made the move as a family, and it was so funny. Members of the church heard that the Osmonds were moving back to Missouri. They would all ask us, is it time? Is it time to go back to Missouri? Well, we would just smile and respond, yeah, didn't you get your letter from the First Presidency? Well, it was just a joke, you know. Well, we finally got out there, and we tried to have the best attitudes we could have. And I'll always remember my first day at Branson High School. Now, the word had spread that the Osmonds were going to be attending the local high school there, but we had no clue what we were in for. We showed up to school the very first day with our BYU shirts on, our CTR rings, and big cheesy grins and on our faces, and we were ready for a great educational experience. Well, the first kid that we met, he asked my brother something. He said, hey, Osmond, are you a Mormon? And my brother, without thinking twice about it, said, yeah, how'd you know? Well, the kid responded, yeah, I hate Mormons. We were like, yeah, I love you too. You know, we weren't expecting them to roll the red carpet out or anything, but that was not the kind of welcome that we were expecting. I had no idea that up until 1978, it was still legal to kill Mormons in the great state of Missouri. The extermination order that was made by Governor Boggs had not yet been taken off the books. Brother Holderby in our ward was the one that found it and had them take it off the books. We had no clue what we were up against. Some of my cousins who were there attending the high school with us, they were spit on by some of the kids. They even had boogers flicked on them by some of the other students. And I don't know about you, but that doesn't seem very Christ-like. My brother's math teacher was one of the heads of the KKK. Well, they don't think too highly of members of this church either. My brother Doug had a knife pulled on him once by a kid who told him he better watch your back, Mormon. And I tell you, you can imagine our response to our parents when we got home. Oh, so this is why we moved out of Utah, huh? Yeah, way to go. Good call. Well, our teachers weren't working with us. Our work schedules, we had to get out of school to go do these shows. And we knew they had some anti-Mormon feelings towards us. Well, we were in a win-lose situation, and we knew we had to get out. Well, I recall sitting in my bedroom one night, just really frustrated. I had my door shut. I just needed some answers. I had been thinking about all those things that we were experiencing day in and day out, and I wanted to know why Heavenly Father had asked us to move. Why did we have to go through all this persecution every day? I remember saying a prayer and asking Heavenly Father to speak to me. Well, I had finished praying. I took my scriptures out, and I held them out over my bed, and with faith, I dropped them on my bed. They opened up to the 64th section of the Doctrine and Covenants, and I started reading, and when I got to verse 33, I knew that Heavenly Father was indeed speaking to me. Verse 33 reads, "Wherefore, be not weary in well-doing, for ye are laying the foundation of a great work, and out of small things proceedeth that which is great." I knew that if I would just hang in there, that if I would make an even greater effort to do the little things like attend church every week and just show by the way I lived that I was indeed a Christian, that I would eventually reach somebody. I knew then and there that we were indeed supposed to be in Missouri at that time and that Heavenly Father had a purpose for us being there. I just needed to try harder and to not give up.